He's an absolutely lovely dude. Okay, genuine, super kind, great rugby philosophy. The only problem is that his accent in English made him sound like Borat, and that was just from day one. That was just too complicated. And from day one, I remember the boys were just choking every time he spoke. The boys were just laughing. Richard Cockerill, his nickname is Cockers. He never called them Cockers. He called them Cock for the whole year. And nobody
That's
could
my
correct him.
nickname.
And nobody could, he's like, yeah, thanks, cock. Now you guys go with cock. And everybody's like, no, you know, we can't. I don't know how much I can swear on this thing, but
A
maybe you'll
lot.
have to bleep or whatever.
Mate,
But in defense.
it's you can swear as much as you like. I you know, if it needs be, I love a good fuck.
I'm sure you do. And I'm glad you do. But, I'll give you an example. In defense, he would basically with his hand, he would wave circulation. You know, you guys, you need to move in the same way, whatever. But his hand is moving from behind him towards his back. You know, something like that. And he's going, but in defense, you have to tell your partner, come inside me, come inside me. And these are the moments that got 35 adults absolutely pissing themselves, and he's like, why are you laughing? Why are you so silly? And Sam Vesti was literally crying of laughter. It was like, Sam Vesti, you have three children. Why are you so sillies? Why are you so sillies? It's just the accent and all of those expressions that you were using that were just too much to handle. And that came in the middle of how actually smart and good he was as a manager. So, you know, when you think it's just not going to work, it's just not the right fit. But he was a legendary nice guy who unfortunately just could not communicate his, in my opinion, could not communicate his ideas to the team.